guys, Jen Spears here. Hope all is well. So, Mason is napping right now. We haven't done any videos of him in a while. He's been sick for the last couple of days. So, I wanted to talk a little bit about medical emergencies and what blind parents need to do or should do. So, a lot of people wonder about that. That is one of the biggest things, I think, for people who don't know about blindness and parenting as a blind person. They wonder about a child's safety. What if your kid stops breathing? What if your kid starts turning blue? What if you have to get to the hospital? So I wanted to talk a little bit about that and share some personal examples. Mason, a month ago, had what is known as the croup, and he has it again, but this time it's not as severe. The croup, for those who don't know, is a nasty cough that can cause what is known as stridor, which is where the esophagus starts to collapse or get inflamed. So it's very, very serious if you don't act on it as soon as you can. It is viral, so they can't give any antibiotics to help it go away. They can do steroids in the office, which is what they did for him. The first time, it did affect his breathing in the middle of the night, so we had to take him to the ER. Before we took him, I called this nurse number that we have for our insurance, and they asked questions. They said, can we listen to him? So they listened to the way that he sounded, and he sounded terrible. So they said, you need to get to the ER as soon as you can. So our plan was to get an Uber and just take him over there. The nurse called us back and said, I'm just going to call you an ambulance. Don't worry, it's covered. So the ambulance showed up and we went to the hospital. We were there for several hours. They monitored his oxygen and gave him steroid treatment. Most terrifying experience of my entire life. Not knowing what was going to happen. I know about the croup because we got it as kids, but I was little, so I don't remember having it. I just know about it because we've been told about it and so on. So we wound up in an ambulance, which is something that even sighted parents have to do sometimes because some things just happen. So it's actually not all that different. If you don't have family around, you can't drive, and Uber is not an option, then sometimes it's just what you have to do. But again, anybody could end up having to do that for speed purposes, to make sure that things are okay and you get to what you need to get to. Now, to go back to, if your kid is turning blue, how do you know about that if you can't see? So here's something that I've done for the past couple of experiences. What I do, with the little bit of vision that I have, I take a picture of Mason and send it to my mom. That way she can look at it and say, he looks blue, he doesn't look blue. And so that's my solution to that. If you have a friend that's sighted or a loved one, take a picture to the best of your abilities. The nice thing about smartphones is some of them will actually tell you that there's a face on the camera. So it's a little bit more accessible these days to take pictures if you don't have any vision at all. So that's a solution for if you think your kid's turning blue. If your kid can't breathe, there are tactile and audible ways to tell that, of course. It's an awful barking sound. I can't even explain it, but it's a sound you don't forget if your kid is having trouble breathing. It can be a wheezy sound, it can be a bark sound, but you can also feel their chest and their ribs and their stomach. The doctor was talking about if their ribs are sticking out, their chest is sticking out, then they're working really hard. So those are some items, food for thought, because it is a concern for a lot of people. I understand, like, if you're a blind parent, what do you do in that situation? So it's not as complicated as people think. You get them to the hospital however you can, whether it's a family member that's close by, a friend that's close by, an Uber, or an ambulance if you have to do that. You know? It's one of those things. You can't play with your kiddo's health. But he's doing okay. He's still playing and he's still eating and drinking. You know, he's a little bit crabby, but you know, who doesn't get crabby when they're sick? Come on now. So that's an update on Mason. I'm sure he'll be better soon. His cough is starting to break up, and so that's that. But once he is better, we will have some cute videos and informative videos on doing things that are still fun. I hope all is well with everyone, like I said. Please ask questions. Please make suggestions. It's always welcome. Thank you for watching. Take care and God bless.